completed my adjustments, Dr. Vogler. You may begin recording.
Thank you, I already have. This is Ulrich Vogel, director of Project End Station. 7th of March, 1944, 10:03 p.m. Commencing cyclotron test run number 12. Dr. Kurtz, please proceed.
All readings are within acceptable parameters. Looks like we are getting the collisions we expected and, some interesting patterns are starting to...
What was that?
I do not know. Gauges are redlining. We have to shut down.
My God, what is happening to the air around the collider?
You men, get away from that!
Project End Station, 12th of March, 1944. 5 days have passed since the accident. I am starting to see it not as a setback, but a breakthrough. Literally. The cyclotron continues to operate, apparently without an external power source. We cannot deactivate it, and it is still manifesting the strange phenomenon I call a rift. And Kurtz calls a wormhole. He attached instruments to the end of a long metal pole and passed it through the rift. The readings confirm that somehow the cyclotron ripped through the fabric of space-time. Something lies on the other side. A parallel world, or perhaps a whole universe. But we dare not approach too closely. Lest we suffer the same fate as the men currently held in our medical clinic. Those men remain in a state best described as living death. Kurtz thinks they caught a high dose of some exotic radiation from the other side of the rift. We are checking their blood and tissue samples for traces of rare elements or otherworldly pathogens. I pray, whatever it is, it is not contagious. Vogel, 16th of March, 1944. We have finally isolated an unknown element in the men who were transformed by the cyclotron accident. And even at this early stage, it is clearly a remarkable substance. For now, we have classified it as Exo-Element 1. Kurtz suggested Vogelium. Such an ass-kisser. The current theory is that, at sufficient concentrations, Exo-Element 1 triggers the horrific transformations experienced by the men closest to the cyclotron rift. I am currently designing a chamber to withdraw Exo-Element 1 from the occupant. My hope is to somehow purify the men and reverse their necrotic condition. If we can learn to control the necrotization process, I believe it could be weaponized. Imagine an army of unkillable soldiers, even at this late point in the war. I may have found the key to saving the Reich. Dr. Kurtz, you have memorized the new orders, yes? Did you burn after reading?
Ja, Vogel. I thought security was tight before the accident. Do you think we can actually accomplish what the Reichstag is asking for?
I would not have suggested it if I did not think it achievable. But let us guard against overconfidence. If we do not deliver, They will find someone who can. And I am not about to give up control of this discovery. All we need is to send through a few volunteers to measure the specific relativistic differential.
Volunteers? Would you take on such a task?
Mind your words, Dr. Kurtz. I would hate for someone to question your commitment.
You are recording this.
What we do now will ensure the Chancellor's dream of a 1,000-year Reich. There must be a record. Ulrich Vogel, Director of Project End Station, 29th of January, 1945. Well, it is finally done. 2 days ago, we bid farewell to those sent here by the Führer to carry out Operation Boulder. Godspeed, heroes of the Reich. Unfortunately, the strain proved too much for the cyclotron. Several seals blew on the cooling unit, and radioactive steam contaminated the station. I ordered an evacuation. The entire staff is gone now, on their way to join our forces in retreat. But with the Red Army advancing, I can only hope they got away in time. As for me, I have chosen to remain and monitor the equipment. I must confirm Task Force Boulder is in position. Everything now rides on their success. I have no illusions about my chances here. This is Soviet territory now, and when they find me, they will surely kill me. But, in a sense, they are already too late. I alone have secured the future of our nation. Forget how proud I am of you. My greatest work, my gift to the world.